Hello everyone and welcome to the video in this section. And in this video we're going to be looking at Qubes OS and why it is probably the best option in terms of operating systems when browsing the deep web. Like literally, this is hands down the best thing or the best operating system that you can use when browsing the deep web. So I'm just going to go to the website right now. I already have it opened. The website is www.qubes-os.org. You can basically get it by just Google searching Qubes OS with a Q, and it's going to be the first website up here. So you just want to open it, and it's a very, very nice website, as you can clearly see. And what's this right here? It says Qubes OS, a reasonably secure operating system. Very, very convincing. But you might be asking yourself, what is Qubes OS? And basically, Qubes OS is a security-oriented operating system. All right? Now, you might be asking, why is this the best option for Tor? Well, I'm just going to give you basically my point on why it's the best and maybe Edward Snowden's advice right here. So if you're serious about security, Qubes OS is the best OS available today. It's what I use and it's free. Now, for those of you who don't know who Edward Snowden is, Edward Snowden is a whistleblower that's currently wanted by the United States for basically leaking information about the CIA, and he's currently wanted, right? And he communicates using this operating system right here, and that really is enough to tell you that this operating system is really secure. So let's get started on how to basically download and install this. So you just want to hit this very, very nice button right here, download and install, and voila, it's going to take you to this page right here. And you want to make sure you download the latest version. As of recording this video, the latest version is Qubes 3.2. I will be updating these videos as newer versions get released. So basically, you want to download, you have two options. You have your ISO version and you have the torrent version of the download, which essentially are both the same. The torrent button right here is just for basically downloading the ISO through torrents. I'm just going to click on ISO, and that's what I recommend you guys would do. It's quite a large file. And by the way, this operating system, when installed, is quite large as well. So I'm just going to hit download. And I already have it downloaded, and we're just going to get started like so. So you guys might be asking, how do I get it installed? Well, that's much. You have two ways of going about it. You can either install it on your USB flash drive and then boot it from your computer, and then install it on maybe install it on another hard drive that you have around, or you could dual boot it with Windows. Or you could basically run it on a virtual machine. But basically, that's really, really very simple. If you're focused on installing it on a USB flash drive, this is how you would go about it. So basically, I'm just going to go to the installation guide. And you want to go into the, basically go down here into the copying the ISO onto the installation medium section right here. And it's going to tell you that you have to use the Rufus tool. That's basically, I think, how you pronounce it. Rufus is basically a program that will allow you to create a bootable USB drive the easy way, as it claims on the website. So just download that right here. I'm just going to download this one right here. It's a very, very small file, 932 kilobytes. Just going to download it, and it should be done right now. And I'm going to run it. Hopefully, it opens up right now. So there we are. Just accept the permission to run it. And do I want to check for updates? No, I really don't need that right now. So just let it run and it should open up right now. All right. So basically what you're going to need is a flash drive, preferably I think 16 gigabytes and above. All right. Now, if you don't have a flash drive of that size, I'm going to show you an alternative way of running Qubes OS. And that's through virtualization, which is, I think, one of the best ways of going about it. But nothing can beat the good old USB installation way. So basically, you select your USB drive right here. Just make sure you select it. I have a 7.8 gigabyte drive in right now. I don't have a 16 gigabyte flash drive plugged in. I do have one, but I don't have it plugged in. You then want to go to this partition scheme and target system type. Just leave that as it is. File system NTFS, just select the FAT32 default. You want to just select the default cluster size, and you want to give it a volume. I'm just going to call it cubes. This is what you basically do. You then want to go down here and select ISO image, and then you want to browse onto where you downloaded your CubesOS ISO file, which is right here. Mine is on the desktop. You just have to go to wherever you saved yours, and I'm going to select mine, and it's going to open. And basically just make sure quick format is enabled and create bootable disk is enabled. All right. Yeah, you can untick this if you don't want an extended label or icon files, and basically just start the installation process. Once this is done, just power off your computer and then boot. You want to boot up into your BIOS mode and select boot from USB flash drive. I'm sure plenty of you guys know how to do that, and just select the flash drive and it should boot up CubesOS, and it should take you through the installation section, which I will get to in a few moments. So what I'm going to do is I am going to basically virtualize this. Now I can go about this by basically downloading a virtualization software. I'm going to be using VMware for this demonstration. So just Google VMware and you want to click on the first link. By the way, this is a free software to download and to use. And just let the website load, and you want to go into, I don't know what's up with the website. All right, so you want to go into the download section, and you want to go into workstation player. All right, so you want to just go into the workstation player and download this one right here. Just download it. I already have it downloaded and installed. It's very, very simple installation to go through. And once you have it installed, just open it up right here. So we have VMware Workstation 12 player. That's the latest version as of recording this video. Alrighty. Now, once it opens, we want to basically go into this section right here. Create a new virtual machine. Alright. So now we want to make sure we select installer disk image file. This has to be an ISO file as it says here. And we're going to say just browse where you saved the ISO file or where you downloaded it. Again, mine is on the desktop. I'm going to click on it and open it. And it's going to give you a warning. Could not detect which operating system is in the disk image. No problem over there. We're just going to hit next. And we're basically going to select a guest operating system as Linux, because CubesOS is based off Linux. And you want to make sure you select Fedora 64-bit, because that is what CubesOS is based off. It's based off Fedora. If your computer is 32-bit, just select Fedora. If it's 64-bit, select Fedora 64-bit and hit next. You want to give it a name. I'm going to call mine CubesOS, and you want to give it, you just want to browse into a directory where you want to save the files that will be associated with this virtual machine. I'm going to be saving mine in my virtual OS folder. You can save yours wherever. It recommends the documents, and you can do that. That's fine. Just hit OK and hit next. Now it's going to ask you for the how the specify the disk capacity. I will recommend 30 gigabytes, and this may come as a shock to you, but it's true. This operating system is huge, and because it has a lot of features, really. So I'm just going to select a maximum disk size of 30 gigabytes. Don't worry if it says recommended size for Fedora. I'm going to store it in a single file. I don't want it to be split into multiple files. Just hit next. You now want to customize your hardware. I'm going to customize my hardware right now. And I'm going to basically give it a memory, which is RAM. I'm going to give it a RAM of 2048 megabytes, which is 2 gigabytes right here. And you can basically just move the slider yourself, really. You then have your processor section. Now, this depends on what hardware you have. If you have a processor that has only 2 cores, you can basically give 1 core. My processor has 4 cores, so I'm going to give 2 cores. And you don't need to touch anything else right here. You now want to go down into your display section and make sure that Accelerate 3D Graphics is checked. And you want to basically select your graphics memory. Depending on your graphics card, I would recommend globally 128 megabytes. If it gives you an error, just select 64 megabytes, depending on what graphics card your computer has. My graphics card has 2 GB dedicated. That's why it's giving me 768 recommended, but I'm just going to stick with 128 MB because anything over that is overkill, really. So I'm just going to hit close, and we can basically say finish. All right. So it's going to give us this very, very nice section here called Cubes OS, which is what we created. And looks like it did not actually create a RAM of 2 GB. So I'm just going to move it to the 2 GB section there, and I'm going to hit OK. And I'm going to start the virtual machine, and it should just start immediately. So there we are, VMware. And it's going to open Cubes OS. So if you see this screen, everything that we've done so far has worked flawlessly. So just let's go up. The text, the selection will be highlighted by white text. I don't want to test the media. I'm just going to say install cubes, the first option, and I'm going to hit enter. And it's going to basically start the installation process. The startup process, really. And let this run. This probably take a few seconds or up to a minute to start up. Alrighty, so once it started up, it should give you this welcome screen right here, the installation welcome screen, and it's going to be telling you welcome to Cubes R3.2 as of this recording. Again, this is the latest version right now, and it's going to ask you what language you would like to run through during the installation process. I would like to use English and English United States. That's what I would really, really enjoy and I would find comfortable. Feel free to use any other language right here. I'm going to hit continue. And it probably should take a few seconds, and we can proceed then. All right, so it's going to give you this very, very nice looking mini menu, which is actually quite professional, I must say. It has reminiscence of Red Hat Linux and very, very top drawer Linux distros. And basically, it's very, very simple to get started with the installation. You want to select, it's divided into sections. You have localization, software, and system. So let's start off with localization. We've basically configured everything right now. So you want to select what keyboard layout you want to use. I'm going to be using English US. You can add another one right here. That's basically good enough for me. What language support you would like to use? Again, we've already selected that, but if you want to feel like you want to add some more, you can add them right here. For example, English India, English Australia. For now, I'm just going to keep mine to English United States. Again, you can do whatever you want, really. You then want to go into time and date and configure it according to what time zone you are in. You can also configure the date. You can also configure the AM/PM system to show it there, to show the AM/PM system. And you can also enable the 24-hour clock, which I like, so I'm going to leave it at that. You can then now move on to the software section and the installation source. We already have configured this, so we really don't need to touch on that. You then want to go into the software selection. Now, in the software selection, it's going to be using the XFCE desktop environment. Now, for those of you who are already familiar with the Linux desktop environments, the XFCE, as you know, is a very, very good desktop environment, and you will be able to change that once it's installed. But for those of you who are not familiar with this, don't worry about any of this. Just don't touch anything right here. Just leave all of this and just hit done. And the last section is the installation destination, basically just selecting the disk that you want to use. Now, we created the 30 GB virtual disk, or the VMware virtual disk. Just select it, and you want to add the disk, and just hit done, and just select this disk. And you want to scroll down here into encryption. Now, if you're going to be using VMware or a virtual machine, disable Encrypt My Data, because this will cause a lot of problems and you won't be able to boot into the operating system once installed. So again, I'm saying just uncheck this. However, if you're installing this through USB, you're installing this on a physical drive, or you're dual booting it with Windows, the installation process is very, very the same thing. You can basically then encrypt my data. You don't need to uncheck this. But if you're running through the installation as I am now, you just want to make sure you just disable encrypt my data. Once done, just hit done. And you should be good to go. Now again, if you're doing this the hardware way, which is basically installing it on another hard drive, you can basically just select the disk right here and just hit automatically configure partitioning. Or if you're experienced enough to do it, you could go into I will configure the partitioning, which I would not recommend for beginners. But if you're doing this the virtual way, which is what I'm doing now, just hit done and you should be good to proceed. Just hit begin installation and it should basically start the installation. The installation will take quite a while, so I'll get back to you guys when it's done. All right, so once the installation is complete, it'll take a while, by the way. It took about 30 minutes for me, and I'm sure it's taken about the same time for you. It's basically gonna say reboot. Now, if you have not basically set your user creation right here, this will not be grayed out. So just go ahead and click it and enter your username and your password. And once that's done, you can basically just hit reboot right here, and that will basically reboot it and you'll be able to use Cubes OS. Now in the next video, I'm going to be showing you basically how you can configure Tor on Cubes OS and how to basically get access to the deep web straight out of the box. And I'm also going to be explaining how to use Cubes OS a little bit, because it is quite a different type of operating system and it works in a very different way. Even for Linux users, this will be it has a learning curve that I will help you to get familiarized with. But that's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you have any questions, just let me know in the Q&A section of the course. Thank you so much for watching.